Bowen's Mill Fish Hatchery is located in Fitzgerald, Georgia. It is one of 7 DNR Wildlife Resources Division hatcheries that hatch and raise warm water fish species to be stocked in water bodies across Georgia. Today, we are following the process of stocking striped bass fingerlings. Bowen's Mill Fish Hatchery primarily works with largemouth bass, bluegill sunfish, and catfish, but will also raise striped bass from recently hatched fry it receives from Richmond Hill Fish Hatchery. The fry are stocked into well-fertilized ponds, feeding off plankton. These fish will be grown until they reach the 1-inch fingerling size, which is ideal for stocking. When the fingerlings are ready to be stocked into water bodies around the state, the hatchery ponds must first be drained. After the pond has drained into a concrete catch basin called a kettle, the fish are scooped out with fine nets called seines and are loaded onto a truck for transport to the hatchery holding house. The fingerlings are loaded into water-filled raceways in the hatchery holding house, where they await loading onto a truck. Once the fish are in the raceways, small samples of fish are counted, weighed, and measured. The average weight of the fish will be used to determine the number of fish that are later loaded in holding tanks. As you can hear, heavy rain rolled in. Fisheries doesn't call on account of rain, so work continued with fisheries staff thoroughly checking and preparing the water in the trucks before adding any fish. They check for pH, dissolved oxygen, alkalinity, and hardness. Some of the fingerlings destined for the Altamaha River are marked with an FDA-approved fluorescent dye. This dye marks the ear bone of the fish. In the future, when fisheries biologists collect samples of fish from the river, they will check for that mark to see if the fish came from a hatchery or was spawned in the river. This mixture is acidic, so a basic chemical is added to return the pH to neutral before fish are added to the tank. Sometimes salt is added to the raceway in order to reduce stress on the fish before they are moved from the raceway to the hauling trucks. Fisheries biologists determine in advance how many fish need to be stocked in a given body of water. The amount of fish needed is then weighed out and added to the tank. Oxygen levels in the tank are checked periodically along the way. The lid is opened as little as possible to avoid shocking the fish. Fortunately, the weather had cleared by the time the truck got to the lake. The tank is backed down a boat ramp into the water and a pump connected. Before fish are introduced into the lake, water conditions in the lake are tested, also for pH, dissolved oxygen, alkalinity, and hardness. These measurements are recorded as data so that fishery staff will know the differences in water quality between the lake and the hauling. Lake water is gradually mixed with tank water so that the fish may slowly acclimate to the different water quality. This process lasts for a minimum of 30 minutes, and the fish are not released until the water chemistry in the tank matches the chemistry in the lake. Before release, a few fish are tested to make sure conditions are right. The fish should be lively and ready to get out into the lake. As you can see, these fish are ready to go. The tank is backed up further into the water, and with a quick release, the fish are away, off to find forage and someday grow into one of the catches that makes Georgia such a great place to fish.